All right, the Grammys were full of wins and losses, but more importantly, fashion hits and misses. So we're going to the pros for this one.
Yeah, our local fashion experts, Kristen Thompson, Jonathan Cavalier, and our own Tracy Beard. Thank you very much for joining us this morning. Late night last night.
Very late.
Very late.
Okay, we got to start here. Who was the biggest win for you on the red carpet?
Mine was Lady Gaga. I think she did a great job. She didn't go over the top like she usually does. I like the simple hair. I like the dress. She did a great job.
Lady Gaga, agree?
She was in the middle for me. I didn't love it. I didn't hate it.
Okay.
Just there.
Yeah. Yeah.
All right, who stood out for you?
That.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Huh. Okay.
So who was your big one?
My favorite was Meghan Trainor. I loved her a lot.
Yes, like, Tracy.
That was enough for me.
I loved it. It was very like 1940s, like Katharine Hepburn type of look, right? And the shoulder pads and like the very loose trouser on the bottom. And then it was a really modern twist though by giving the plunging neckline and the accents of the sparkles on the shoulders and around her waist. I loved it. She kept her hair back so you can focus on the plunging neckline, and the makeup is very, very soft. Now, if you're wearing white, which makes it really modern and crisp, most people think, oh, go with a bold lip. But if she had went with a bold lip, then it would have taken away from the plunging neckline.
Been too much,
so
right?
I think the makeup was perfect. I think the hair was perfect off of her shoulders. The whole look, I loved it from head to toe. It was like 40s with a modern twist.
Wait, someone did not like Meghan Trainor.
I didn't like it. I feel like she tried. I feel like it didn't go over well. I don't feel the fit was great. And I actually really like her, but I thought it was a no.
Jonathan, you've been silent up until now.
I thought Post Malone was incredible. I thought he was inherently himself.
I liked
I liked the pink. I think he had a really cool like Midwestern 70s vibe going on. So he was definitely my favorite. He was a standout.
Standout. What about, let's talk about some of the guys too. Who was good, who was not good?
I liked Miguel.
I liked Miguel. We'll agree on that.
Yeah, yes. Okay. I loved Miguel. He was wearing purple, like shiny kind of pants. I just think if you're going to the Grammys, it's time to have fun. Okay. Mm-hmm. All those other award shows are to be serious. He was wearing purple. He was wearing like a white blazer with like silver or like sparkle along the lining of his lapel. I just loved it. It was fun, but it was very chic. But I liked it.
It's harder for guys though, isn't it, to really do anything?
Yeah.
Because you're trying to outstage these massive productions that these women put together. How can you do it?
I think that the best thing for guys to do is really stick to something classic, but find a twist on it. So like either something fitted, very fitted, something a little oversized. Like I think like finding little twists to it to make it like your own is a great way to do it.
Or adding color.
Yeah, for sure. I think, taking those traditional staples and just kind of elevating them a little bit, right? So in the example of Post Malone, he does something that's, typically, a cowboy, whatever, for example, but he's wearing it in pink and he has embroidery all over it, right? So just doing it a little bit differently.
And Tracy's right, though. This is the carpet. Like, it's not the Oscars. It's not the Golden Globes. This is the carpet where you can be a little bit more gutsy. You can try different things. But with that, this is where our panel is divided. It's J-Lo.
Okay.
J-Lo, no?
I liked it. When I first saw it, I was confused. Mm-hmm. I was like, I don't know if I like it. Then it started to grow on me. I get what she was doing. Again, if you're going to do this is the award show to do it at. She can't do this at the Oscars or something like that. This is the award show to have some fun, and I think that's fun. It's very, it's very like a Mexican inspired. That's the feel that I got from it with that hat and also with the very high neck. I loved it in that ponytail. You saw a lot of these hats on the red carpet and people doing a long braid with it. It's very Mexican inspired. I liked it. I thought this is the award show to have fun.
Uh-oh, go ahead.
Just looking at those heels.
It was definitely interesting. I think we hold J-Lo at a very high standard. She's one of those people that like you look to for fashion. And when you compare that outfit to the classic Grammy green dress, it didn't do it for
me.
But I love her.
For sure. I think it fails in comparison to that one. I thought the exact same thing, though. When I first saw her, I was like, what's going on? But it grew on me. It grew on me over time.
I love the hat. I thought the hat
it
was so over the top. It was just great fun.
That's Grammys.
Yeah. When she walked out with Michelle Obama and everybody.
But like, tilt your hat up. Tilt it up. We want to see your eyes. We want to see what's happening under there. No, you like the mystery.
Yeah, I like the mystery of it. I liked it. I liked it.
Okay, we want to hear from, thank you so much to our expert panel, even though you didn't agree whatsoever. All right, cool. That's what questions I know, right? You can play.
Yeah.
And we want to hear from the kids.
Yeah.
So we have our BT Fashion panel with the kiddies, so tweet us.
at BT Toronto. We've had a few already. Yep. Last night, there were some, before they went to bed, before the kids went to bed, they were offering their critiques of some of the outfits, and we want some more. So at BT Toronto, send them in. Let's head upstairs now to Tam. Thank you very much, guys. Tam?